Wanna play Halo Infinite, but aren't sure whether your laptop can run it? Welcome to Yes But Actually No, where we rate how well the game runs on obsolete toasters on the scale of Yes But Actually No. Feel free to skip to the part that interests you the most. Here we have an overpowered laptop, in the terms of the CPU, the Ryzen 4600H, paired up with a GPU on its last dying breath, the GTX 1650 Mobile. This specific GPU model is paired up with GDDR6 VRAM, which will improve performance by a staggering 0%. This improvement, however, is compensated with a reduced core count from 1000 to roughly 896, to make sure you get as least performance as possible. There are 16GB of DDR4 memory, however, 8 is somewhat sufficient. As our storage option, I've opted for the lightning-fast 5.4K RPM HDD instead of an SSD. It simply isn't necessary for the multiplayer alone. And as our spyware, we will be using Windows 10, as there is not a single reason to go to Windows 11. Next up, we can see some trash gameplay recorded from the laptop at low settings in 1080p. The frame rate is visible in the upper left corner, and at the end, I will point out the key factors of running this game on this laptop, and I will rate it on the Yes But Actually No scale.
What a shot!
Few important things to point out. Once you download the game, you might not be able to get past the final boss of the game, the intro screen. Here is a list of things you might need to do in order to get past this menace. Pause the video if needed. Also, I have seen a lot of people complaining on the load times, that having an SSD is a must. Here is how long it takes to load a map using a 5.4K RPM HDD. I have seen people claim that using these slow HDDs will make opening Word documents last minutes. Yet, big maps in Halo load in roughly 37 seconds while recording. Do with that what you will. However, when you do run Halo for the first time, it will load slow as hell, as it seems to be compiling all the data. This will only happen once for the first time you open the game and the first time you load each of the maps. After everything is compiled, the load times will be satisfactory. In conclusion, on the scale of yes but actually no scale, Halo Infinite barely gets a yes. The game is stable, you get about 50 to 60 frames per second in 1080p, depending on the game mode. The game typically has no stutters and does not freeze. Despite the low settings, the game looks visually acceptable. Also, don't use asynchronous computing for the GPU unless you're using an AMD GPU. Next up, actual performance numbers while not recording in 900p and 1080p. Subscribe for more and have fun. Round 5.